In this video, I explain hydraulic circuit or a hydraulic systems. In this hydraulic system, the one single acting cylinder, SAC means single acting cylinder, is used, and this single acting cylinder is operated by using 1/4x2 DCV. DCV means directional control valve. So I explain this video by using the animation so you can understand it easily. So we know that 3/2 DCV, DCV means directional control valve. So 3/2 DCV is required to operate a single acting cylinder. But if you don't have 3/2 DCV and instance you have a 4/2 DCV, means suppose the 3/2 DCV is not available, okay, and you have the 4/2 DCV, then how you can use the 4/2 DCV in a single acting cylinders? So then no problem, you can use it by closing any one of its cylinder ports. So in a 4/2 directional control valve, we have the two port. One is the port A and another is the port B, okay, as an outlet. Okay, so out of these two, we need to block the any one of the cylinder ports, then we are able to use 4/2 DCV for a one single acting cylinders. 4/2 DCV has the two cylinder ports, namely the cylinder port A and the cylinder port B. So here you see, this is the general hydraulic system diagram, that is the oil reservoir, suction pipe, pump. Pump is run by using the motor. This is the outlet of the pump, that is here the pressure port. This is the return line. In return line you see the filter. This is pressure relief valve and the pressure gauge. Okay, now here we need to use the 4/2 DCV, means here we need to draw the 2 square. So second digit is 2, that means that have a 2 position. For the 2 positions we need to draw 2 square, and that is a 4 port. So here you see this port P, this is port T, and here the port A, okay, and this is the port B, and during that oil is flow from P to A and B to T. Here you see this is the second positions. In a second position 4 port is there, okay, that is a, here you see this is the port P and it is connected with B. Port A is connected with the T, and this directional control valve is operated by using the manual lever. So here you see this is the one outlet from the port A, this is the second option, that is a B. Okay, so out of these two, here you read that if there is only one single acting cylinders, then connect any one of the cylinder ports to the single acting cylinders and plug to the another cylinder ports. Okay, now suppose we use this 4/2, so we are able to connect the two single acting cylinders. Okay, so A port is connected with cylinder A, B port is connected with the cylinder B. That theory I already explained in a last video. Okay, but here we have only one single acting cylinder, so we have option, we either block the A port or either block the B port. Okay, so here we block this B connection port here. Okay, you see the sign of the cross. Okay, so this is the block the B, so no oil is supplied from the B port to the hydraulic system because it is the block. We have, you also block the port A. Okay, it's depend on you, it is not necessary to always block the port B. Now the 4/2 DCV is act as the 3/2 DCV. Why? Because out of 4 ports, one is plug means we block it, okay, and only the 3 are remaining. Okay, so B port is blocked. Here we have only the 3 port that open, that is A, P and T. So this 4/2 directional control valve is work as a 3/2 directional control valves. So 4/2 DCV has the two positions of its pulse that we already explained. For the two positions we need to draw the 2 square. Suppose here the 4/3 DCV is there, then we need to add the another square. Okay, so in the next video I explain about the 4/3 DCV. So here you see from the port A, it is connected with this single acting cylinders. Okay, here A is written. So this is the cylinder, this is the piston, this piston rod, and it is a spring return type. Okay, now before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe my channel for watching the more video related to the OHP and another subject of the mechanical engineering. For the more video of the circuit designs, the link is provided in the description as well as from the card. Card means on a top right screen of your laptop or mobile, you see that is I symbol is there. In I symbol, I put the various playlist of the subjects. From that you can able to watch the more video. Now Here we understand the first positions of the single acting cylinders. In a first positions of the spool of 4 by 2 dcv, oil under the pressure flow from P to A and B to T are closed. Hence the single acting cylinder is extended. Here you see the P pot is connected with the A. Okay, means oil is coming from the reservoir to the pump. Pressurized oil is coming at the here pot P. Pot P to it is supplied at the pot A. Okay, and from the pot A, this oil is enter into the single acting cylinders. Okay, and this pressurized oil applied the some force on the piston, and due to this force, piston is start to move in a downward directions. Okay, that means it is called as the extend. So single acting cylinder is extend here written. Okay, and B and T are closed. So here you see that is a B pot is closed. Okay, but suppose this B pot is connected with some another cylinder, then what happen? Oil from this cylinder is come into the B pot, and from B to T it is go to the return. But here what you see, B pot is blocked, so no oil is entering B pot. So no oil in a B pot means no oil in a T pot. So here what the written, B and T are the closed. Now we understand the second position. Now here you see the diagram is changed and you see the animation. This is the first position. Okay, then after what, how the we achieve the second positions? By operating the directional control valve. So we apply some force on the directional control valve. So here you see the position is changing. Okay, 1 to 2, 2 to 1 by operating using the manual force. Okay, so this is the first position. Here you see the second positions. Okay, so here you see this is the second positions of the directional control valve. So here what you see, in a second positions of the spool of 4 by 2 dcv, oil under the pressure flow from A to T and B and P are closed. Means here you see the P is connected with the B. Okay, but you know that here the B is blocked. Means pressurized oil is not supplied to the, okay, it's go to B pot, but it is not supplied further to the hydraulic system. That's why it is written as the closed. Okay, and here what the written, A and T are open. So here this is a A pot, and A pot is connected with T pots. Okay, so how the oil is coming in A pot? Okay, again in earlier case, here you see that we supply P to A. Okay, but here we use the single acting cylinders, and it is a spring return type. Okay, so when the extension is over, the piston is start to move from the bottom to top directions, means in a upper direction. Why? Due to the spring force. Okay, so they start to move in upper direction. Then what happened? The oil in upper part of the piston is supplied to this pipe. Okay, A part here is coming A pot, this green color pipe, and from the green color it is go to the here coming A pot, and from the A pot it is going T pot, and it is go to the oil reservoir through the filters. Okay, so during the second positions the cylinder is retracts. Okay, for the more video of different hydraulic systems and circuits, the link is provided in the descriptions as well as in a card symbols. So thank you for watching this video. If you learned, then like the video, subscribe the channels, and don't forget to share with your friend.